Have you ever come out of the movies or watched a movie at home and felt mind blown? Like it changed the way you think about something or even yourself. Or maybe you're going through a difficult time in your life and you randomly watch a movie that seems to give you, it's almost like the path forward. Perhaps it helped you see your challenges in a different light, make sense of them, and then find the right way forward in dealing with them. It could be a specific line spoken that you just can't stop thinking about, or the storyline opens up your mind to new possibilities. This is the power of film. Maybe you sat down to watch a movie to be purely entertained, and you come away from it reflecting on the takeaway messages for days, literally obsessed by the words spoken. I know Yoda from Star Wars has given us many takeaway quotes. Do or do not. There is no try. Such poignant words. Now, movies have the power to make us cry, laugh, or be scared and petrified. We might go into a movie feeling good and come out feeling unnerved or even teary. We've all been there. Where are the tissues when you need them? Has anyone seen Marley? And if you're a dog lover, it really hits the spot. Or you instantly start checking the locks on the doors at home. Anyone watch the Scream movies recently? But on a more serious note, we watch emotional movies, we release oxytocin, a chemical that can create empathy and emotion. And warning, this may lead to fluid leaking from your eyes. Did you know that the movie The Conjuring 2, which was in 2016, it led to a 65-year-old man collapsing at the end and actually dying. Now, this movie also led to many people claiming their homes had become haunted just by watching the movie in their own house. Now, this is creepy. Now, Warner Brothers encouraged this hype by hiring a priest to bless the movie set and come to screenings in the film to bless the audiences in the Philippines. So what leads to our minds becoming absorbed by the movies we watch? Why do we jump or flinch when an actor is hit by a bus or something is thrown? How does looking at a movie screen allow us to experience the very thoughts and feelings of the characters? And why do some movies just have such a lasting influence on us? So many questions and so little time. There are a handful of movies that have had a strong and lasting emotional and psychological impression on me. And just to name a few, just off the top of my head, there's Shawshank Redemption.
I guess it comes down to a simple choice, really. Get busy living, or get busy dying.
There's Groundhog Day.
What day is this?
It's February 2nd. Groundhog Day.
There's Elvis by Baz Luhrmann.
We're lost in a cloud with too much rain.
And the classic movies of Robert De Niro, Deer Hunter, which I watched just recently a couple weeks ago. And of course, the other classic, Taxi Driver.
You talking to me?
Now, there are literally so many hundreds and thousands of movies that I could mention, but they are the ones that hit me just now. It's funny how the Groundhog Day movie was released in 93, and I still hear the younger generation saying, "This feels like Groundhog Day."
Punxsutawney Phil.
That's right, woodchuck chuckers. It's Groundhog Day! Get up and check that hog out there!
Yeah!
Sooey, sooey. Come here, Groundhog!
If you haven't seen Groundhog Day, I highly recommend it. It centers around a somewhat narcissistic, self-centered weatherman, played by Bill Murray, who's one of my serious favorites, finding himself in a time loop on Groundhog Day. The day keeps repeating until he learns the value of caring about others and eventually demonstrating gratitude and perseverance. It's a story mainly about self-redemption.
I'm a god.
You're a god.
I'm a god. Not the God, I don't think.
Now, the already mentioned movies and many more have made me think deeply and feel for very different reasons. Now, Shawshank Redemption has so many memorable quotes that hit hard, too many to mention. Now, here are a few that I can remember.
Went up and vanished like a fart in the wind.
Get busy living, or get busy dying.
It's the best part.
It's not just the older movies with the ability to invoke strong emotion and contemplation either. The Baz Luhrmann Elvis movie has left so many moviegoers shedding a tear with its emotional end scene. Now, I won't ruin it for those of you that haven't seen it yet, but I highly recommend you watch it. There's also the 2020 animated movie, Soul.
Must have been sudden for you.
And also The Father with Anthony Hopkins.
You're living with your daughter at the moment?
Yes, until she goes to live in Paris.
No, Dad, why do you keep going on about Paris?
You told me.
No, I didn't.
I'm sorry, Anne, you told me the other day.
They will certainly stir some emotions and seriously make you think. And to come back to a question asked earlier, why do we jump in our seats or flinch when watching a movie? Basically, in a nutshell, the answer is that we all have a lifetime of experiences outside of movie watching on how to deal with danger, physical objects, and movements in general. You know, it's called the fight, flight, freeze, appease mechanism. In terms of risk, did you flinch? We don't turn this off when we sit down to watch a movie. We become engrossed in the movie and our bodies respond similarly. It's frightening. And last, but by no means least, movies provide a form of almost like escapism, a chance to escape from the real world in which you can feel the sensations and emotions experienced by characters, providing a distraction from the sensation and emotions felt in your real life problems and situations. Now, I'm sure you've come back from a hard day at work or a stressful situation and just flopped down on the couch to watch your favorite movie or TV show, right? Something to take your mind off the problems for a while. And I think we can all say sometimes that's exactly what the doctor ordered. So I hope this has given you something to think about. And if nothing more, it has prompted you to watch some of the movies I mentioned today. Now I'll finish with the words of Carmen from South Park. Bye for now.
We have to see this movie, dude.
Ah, screw it. It probably isn't all that good anyway.
Carmen, what are you talking about? You love Terrence and Phillip. Let me have some candy, Cartman.
Oh, let's see. Nope, I don't have any Jewish candy.
Like, you really need all that chocolate, fat boy. Ba 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 ba.